here is my breakfast, lunch, and dinner for today. Sorry, breakfast, lunch, and snack. You'll notice it's very light on points, which means it's a whole lot of fruit. The reason for that is because I am hopefully going to dinner with a friend tonight. And I say hopefully, but if it falls through, I'm gonna be really annoyed since I'm literally just eating mostly fruit today. So my breakfast is coffee. I'm having my coffee black this morning. And then I don't know if I'm literally gonna eat the orange and the pear and the kiwi. I'm probably gonna start with the pear and the kiwi. And the orange is kind of a just in case. My lunch over here, I do still have my one smart point wrap because I find it's just so filling for one smart point that it's totally worth the point. It's the Olay Extreme Wellness Wrap for one, a slice of Kraft Singles for zero, five slices of turkey for zero, a teaspoon of sweet relish for zero, jalapeno mustard for zero, and sliced apple. And then I have this gigantic Granny Smith apple on the side. I find that apples are also super, super filling. And then for my snack today, I have this apple and orange here, but I also have at work some applesauce that I might heat up, and I have a sugar-free apple cider mix that I might heat up. It's very cold and rainy today. Typically when I eat like this, when I'm prepping to go out to dinner, I probably eat half this fruit and I'm still very satisfied. So most of this is kind of just in case fruit, but yeah, this is my very boring but very functional day today. One smart point so far, and I will talk with you later. Good morning, everyone. So I am on my way to work. I just showed you what I'm going to have today for my breakfast, lunch, and snack. And I just want to let you know, if you are a new watcher, I do not eat like that all the time. That's like almost a 0 point day. I do not do that all the time. It's simply a strategy that I have when I know I'm going to go out to eat and I know the points at dinner are gonna be high. There might be a lot of wine involved. This is just a strategy that I use to help balance my points. So with what I have planned for dinner already and the food that I'm going to eat throughout the day, I'm going to a very nice Italian restaurant. There are not a lot of, I don't know, I think I picked like the lowest fat options they have available. I can't remember what it is right now, but I'm gonna have, I know one of them is a beet salad I'm going to have, and I think the other one was like grilled octopus with potatoes and tomatoes. So there's gonna be sauces involved, just not like super low points food. So, but I did already choose what I'm going to have, and combine that with the food that I already showed you today is going to be a 30 point day. So let's hope I can stick to that. I'm also a little annoyed because the restaurant, the dinner date is not completely confirmed right now. So like I said yesterday, people do not realize that I literally plan my entire day around dinner. So if you want to make plans with me, please follow through. Don't cancel the day of. I just find that really annoying. I guess I've really turned into a planner. So I like to know what I'm eating, when I'm eating, where I'm eating. So there's that. I am on my way to the doctor, and it's just super rainy out today. I'm already late. I'm not gonna speed and drive crazy. There's nothing I can do. Californians just do not know how to drive in the rain, and I don't understand it. It's just rain. It's not snow. It's not ice. It's just rain, you guys. What is the problem? So yeah, I'm probably gonna be pretty late to the doctor. But I am on my way, and hopefully she has good news for me. I did find out that maybe, possibly, I may be starting my period, so that could help explain at least part of the 10-pound water gain. So it may be something to do with that. And then I also have a bit of good news this morning. I had ordered some clothes online in the fall. I actually ordered a sweater dress, And I thought, okay, maybe I'm a medium and I don't want this sweater dress to be super tight and clingy. So I'm gonna order a large. So I ordered a large and it came and it was just huge. I sent it back and ordered a medium. And when the medium came, it was huge. It didn't look right. I think part of it is that this dress is supposed to be a little bit clingy to kind of like give you some shape. So I sent it back and I ordered the small. Then it was on back order. So I just got the small this week and I have not even tried it on because it's just too cold to even think about wearing it now. So I may need to wear shapewear with it, but I'm pretty sure it'll probably fit. Anyway, from the same company then, I decided I was gonna order a pair of jeans, and I decided to just go for it and order the size 6 based on my experience with having to send this dress back like 3 times. So I ordered the size 6 jeans, and I was a little nervous because the last size 6 pair of jeans I bought were stretch skinny jeans from Old Navy, which I love. They are my favorite jeans. They're a little tight down at the calves, so they make my lower legs look like kind of weirdly skinny, but I love them because they make me look great up top in the belly and the hip area. So I thought, okay, I'm just gonna take the plunge and order the size 6. They came last night and they fit. So does that mean I'm really a size 6? Like I can really truly say that I am for real a size 6? I don't know, because that's awesome. But yeah, I'm going to get another pair because these are like a stone gray pair. I want to get like maybe a dark wash denim or maybe a medium, I haven't decided. But I'm going to order the 4 next time because these fit well enough and with a little bit of room. I like my jeans tight, so yeah, I'm gonna get a 4 next time, but it's my little bit of super good news for this rainy Wednesday is that I am a size 6. Anyway, I am gonna head over to this doctor's appointment. I had to wake up super early, so 6:30. That's early to me because I usually wake up at 7 or 7:30, so it's really only half an hour's difference, but man, it felt early. I'm definitely not a morning person, but I am a little more than I used to be. Anyway, I will keep you guys updated on what the doctor says. Hopefully I can run at lunch today. I brought all my stuff, all my shower gear. I'm hoping for it. And I am proud to say that I did not weigh this morning. So I'm gonna try and go another week without weighing. If part of it's my period and part of it is the weird water thing, then I should be down part of those 10 pounds by next Tuesday. So that's what I'm hoping for. That's what I'm clinging to. So yeah, I'll check in with you guys later. Bye. Hi guys, so I am back. I am done with the doctor's appointment. It was a piece of cake. I did an EKG, which was totally normal. My heart rate was actually a little low, which she said is normal from the amount of exercise that I do. There was nothing abnormal in my heartbeat. She could not hear anything. So it's all good. She actually is sending me to do a treadmill stress test later this afternoon. So I will do that. And then once that comes back normal, then I should be good to go, but she did not find anything, so that makes me feel better. Maybe it was just a weird thing. I don't know. It was the kind of chest pain that I have never felt before in my life, so it was scary, and I do feel better just getting it checked out and just knowing, you know, I'll feel better when they say everything is fine and you can run and you're healthy. So I had to get a tetanus shot. That kind of hurt. Not as bad as I thought it would. Thought it was going to be really painful, but I'll probably be feeling it later. He said it hurts for a couple days. So I had to get a tetanus shot and clean bill of health on an EKG so far. I am headed to work, so I will work for a few hours and then head out this afternoon for the treadmill stress test, which literally should be a piece of cake. Like, I'm on the treadmill every day, so I'm not worried about it. And honestly, at this point, I think it's probably gonna come back fine. So right now it's just like, let's just follow this through and just make double sure that everything is fine. So yeah, I'm good. I'm headed back to work, or I'm headed to work. I haven't been there yet. I have a meeting this morning, and then it's same old, same old. So I will check in with you guys later. Bye. Hi guys. So it is about 3 o'clock, and I am headed to the cardiologist to do a stress test on the treadmill. My friend that I was supposed to have lunch with today canceled. How did I know that was coming? I just knew that was gonna happen. So we are supposed to go next Thursday to the same restaurant. The good thing is that I was able to go onto the Weight Watchers app, and everything that I had entered that I was going to eat tonight, I was able to just move all of that over to next Thursday. So next Thursday when we go to this restaurant, it's already pre-tracked for me. I know what I'm gonna order, I know what I'm gonna have, so that's good. I guess the other good news is that I have a lot of points left for dinner. Like, a lot of points. Like, my whole day, 29 points. So I haven't really even been hungry today, so all of the fruit that I brought this morning, I'm pretty much just taking it all back home. I had one pear this morning, and then I did have the turkey wrap, so because I love that turkey wrap, and that turkey wrap is super filling. It is so worth 1 point, believe me. So that's all I've eaten today, is a pear and my turkey wrap. So I have tons of fruit left, I have tons of points left. I also went walking at lunch, so I was going to walk outside because it's super nice and sunny, but it was still too cold. So I walked on the treadmill at lunch, I walked for 3 miles, and so I got a decent amount of steps in. So all in all, a good day. Not super productive at work because I was gone in the morning and then I had a meeting for about an hour. But hopefully I can make up for that tomorrow. Hopefully they told me that this stress test would not take very long. And actually after this morning's visit, I'm really expecting that they're not gonna find anything. So in a way that's good. No, that's really good, of course. But on the other hand, you know, I want them to tell me what the problem was, why I was feeling those pains the other day. So if they don't have an answer, then what do I do? You know, chalk it up to a one-time experience, and if it happens again, go back? I don't know. So, but I really expect that it's going to be nothing, and I'm going to get the okay. I did ask my doctor before she made this appointment if I could run still, and she said, go ahead. But maybe just run at a lower intensity than you have been. So, and then she scheduled the stress test for me. So I'm gonna ask the cardiologist about running, and you know, as long as this test comes back okay with no issues, I'm just gonna double check and make sure, is it okay for me to run? And my guess is that he's gonna say yes. And so after I'm like done with work for the day, I just took the rest of the day off. So after this appointment, I am headed to the gym. Gonna get my run on. So that's as long as everything's okay. So that's all I got going on right now. I will update you guys after this stellar cardiology appointment and let you know how everything is. Okay, talk to you later. Hi guys, so it is later. I am done with the treadmill test, which was, I have to say, slightly challenging. Everything is a green light, except I don't have the okay to run yet. Everything was totally fine with the treadmill test. My heart rate was fine. My blood pressure was fine. The EKG was fine. There was nothing weird showing on the EKG. Everything was perfect. I think I maxed out at like 83% something on the heart rate at like, I believe it was 5-something miles an hour at 68% incline. That's tough, because this girl does not run hills. So 68% incline was really hard, and that really got my heart rate going, and no pain at all. So I don't know if maybe my heart rate was just like way too high the other day when I was running, or I don't know. The nurse didn't know. He said everything is 100% perfect. I ran for either 14 or 15 minutes, which he said is longer than most people can go, and I did great. So he told me to wait until my primary doctor gets the results from the cardiologist tomorrow and clears me to run. So I was hoping to run tonight. I was hoping to run tomorrow, and I can't do anything. But I did hit my 13,000 steps, so I'm happy about that. And I am headed home early. I'm happy about that. I am unfortunately stuck in Hollywood traffic, and I'm going 9 miles an hour. So I might not be home early, but at least I got to leave early. It looks like Eddie wanted to make chicken and pasta for dinner, but I actually already tracked that for tomorrow. So I was like, can we just have tamales, because I have a lot of points left, so I could have 2 tamales instead of just 1. So I think I'm gonna have tamales. He does not like the tamales, so he's probably gonna have chicken. He can eat chicken literally every day for days and days and days on end. So I've had chicken for 2 days in a row. I think I'll take a break tonight, and then I'll do chicken and pasta tomorrow. So that's my plan for dinner. I got nothing else going on for the night. I should really do something productive or something exciting. Like, I have this latch hook rug kit that I've had since like way before Christmas that I haven't even worked on for a while. I did work on it over Christmas, but I haven't touched it since then. It's fun. It's relaxing. As Oprah would say, it's me time. So I think I'll do some of that tonight. So I'm headed home for dinner, and I will touch base with you guys when I eat. Bye. Okay guys, finally it is 7:38, and here is dinner. And what did I decide to have? No tamales, but chicken. I decided I was pretty hungry by about 7:30, 7 o'clock, because all I had today was the 0-point pear and the 1-point turkey wrap. So I wasn't really hungry most of the day, and I was just running around and doing stuff. So, but by about 7 o'clock, I was pretty hungry, and I decided if I have the chicken salad versus just 1 or 2 tamales with salad, I'll get a lot more for less points. So I decided on chicken. Here is my chicken salad. I am using this Taylor Farms organic 50-50 blend for my lettuce. For the chicken, I have this Tyson grilled and ready chicken breast strips. I have 6 3/4 ounces for 3 smart points. I have 1 tablespoon of cranberries for 1 smart point, and 1 tablespoon of pepitas for 1 smart point. And then I also have this Bolthouse Farms chunky blue cheese yogurt dressing, 2 tablespoons for 1 smart point. So that is 3, 4, 5, 6 smart points in my salad. I also diced up some tomatoes and some bell peppers. I'm having the same red blend that I had last night. And I just wanted to say a couple things about this Tyson Grilled and Ready. First of all, I told Bless B earlier, I was like, my husband does not really like me to buy this because since he is the main cook in our house, he would rather cook the chicken himself than to spend the extra money on this. And also he thinks it's saltier than just plain regular chicken breast. But what I wanted to point out is that I have 6 3/4 ounce of these chicken breast strips on my salad, and the app says 6 3/4 ounces is 3 smart points. When I do 6 3/4 ounces of regular chicken breast cooked, it is 4 smart points. So I don't know what they're doing to this chicken, but I did notice that Bless B is using this also, and she's using chicken breast fillets, I believe. And each of her chicken breast fillets or chicken breast pieces is only 1 smart point. So it's a lot of protein for very few smart points. It's also super fast because all you have to do is heat it up in the microwave. It does say 100% all natural, so I don't know. There's got to be salt in here somewhere because I do feel like it tastes a little salty as well.
It's also a little on the dry side.
It's not dry if you don't overcook it. This says boneless, skinless chicken breast with rib meat, water, chicken flavor, dextrose flavors, garlic powder, maltodextrin, molasses, natural flavor, onion powder, rice, starch, salt, spice, and sugar. So how can they add all those things to the chicken breast and yet it comes out less smart points than just plain cooked chicken breast? I don't understand that. Anyway, so here's my dinner for tonight, a big old chicken salad, and I'm gonna go dig in. Hi guys, so it's Wednesday night and dinner's over, work's over, we're watching TV. I'm just gonna close out the blog. I'm having one last little snack because I have a whole smart point left. So I'm having one little snack, this Hormel turkey pepperoni. I love it because it tastes like real pepperoni to me. And you can have 15 of these for 1 smart point. You can have 5 of them for 0 smart points, 15 for 1 smart point. I just gave one to my husband and let's find out how he liked it. Did you like these?
Oh yeah, they were really good. You have to let it melt in your mouth.
If you pull it out of the freezer.
The first taste, as soon as it hits your tongue, it tastes like grease. So I guess it tastes like pepperoni.
Isn't that what pepperoni tastes like?
Yeah, but now I kind of feel like I have to brush my teeth.
But did you like it?
Yeah, it was good.
Would you eat it again?
Yeah, give me another one.
Would you have it on pizza?
Give me another one so I can show
it. Would you have it on pizza?
I guess. Give me another one. No, I can't put it in my hand in the bag.
Oh my gosh, he can't reach in the bag himself. It's not greasy. It's not greasy. Here, I'll give you one.
So this is 1.
Yep, you can have 5 for 0 smart points.
I thought you said 15.
You can have 15 for 1 smart point.
Oh. Well, why can't you have 6 then?
If you have 6, it turns into 1 smart point.
But you know what? You can have 15.
Don't even question that.
I don't understand.
You can have 6 to 15. You can have 6 all the way up to 15 for 1 smart point. Don't question it. It is what it is.
But 15, well, wait, if you have 6, 6 times 2, that'd be 12. How do they come up with 15?
I don't know. It's like a rounding thing.
Yeah. You round it to 12.
It's a rounding process. Don't question it. It's math.
But if it's...
It's okay. Math. It's yeah, science. It's
wait,
math and
wait,
it's
wait,
science.
Wait. Stop,
okay,
stop,
this
stop,
video
stop.
Is over.
Stop.
Bye.
But if it was 12, it should be rounded down to 10.
I think Eddie needs to contact 24/7 chat. And maybe they can answer his question. Anyway, with 15 of these...
Points.
With 15 of these... I've only had 1 so far. I'm going to have 14 more. With 15 of these, I will be at 30 smart points for the day.
My step count, ooh, one moment. I am at 15,625 steps. I also went to the gym before I came home and did my 10 minutes on the rower. So I am tracking everything. I'm within my points for today, and I did my exercise for the day, and I did my 13,000 steps. Kind of the same, but you know. Anyway, I am ending this vlog here. I will check in with you guys tomorrow.
Bye-bye.